go. First stream with new RAM, a new webcam. Let's see how this goes. Hey Zido, good afternoon. How's it going? Just thought I'd do a test stream. Seemed like a good time to start. Yeah, it seems to be alright so far. I haven't got the SSD in yet, so that's something I've got to set up first. But my brother's gonna have a look at that and see how it goes. But if they can't do it, I can always take it in somewhere local. I won't go to that place in Newcastle again because it took like a week to get it back. But I wanted to at least try and do it myself, but I guess it was just against against my skill level. The SSD, well, where it goes in, there's the hard drive and the original SSD, and I think there's a slot above it, but it might need a bracket, I don't know. And I also need to know whether I can actually install it to the motherboard. But that's beyond my level. And there's a lot of cables in the way, and I don't know what goes where. So my nephew built his own PC, so he knows a bit more what to do in that situation. But in the long run, if there's not a spot, I can always remove the old hard drive and swap that to the SSD instead, which means I'd have to back up my hard drive with all my Steam folders. It's actually a SATA one. If you can see that, I don't know if it's showing on camera or not. It's a 2.5 SATA drive, Samsung. I don't know, it's where the hard drive is and where the SSD is. There's a spot above, but there's no bracket. But I'm just wondering whether I can fit one. Fit it over the top of the original SSD. But that's a question for my nephew. It's something I'm not going to mess with myself. I might need to buy a bracket for it because there's no bracket there. Arc L5, Crew L5. Yeah, that's what I might need to do. I might need to get the cables for it as well. Where's Arc L5? this map. So, what was it again? Crew of five. Arrow of five. Kill five. Ah, kill. Yeah. There's a lot of cables in there, and I'm not sure what's attached to what, though. But at least the stream's looking good. I've got a brand new like ring camera, so it's got like a little light that goes around it, and I can brighten it just by tapping it if I want to look all sickly and bright. Ah, well, I am. Cool. So, here we go. And I've sort of redone everything on me stream as well. So, like, got this. The chatting set up. End scene. Starting. And I got new alerts too. No problems, Idol. Have a good one.
Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
Yeah, I did have a big overlay and it was just too ugly. It took up a lot of the screen space. So I've simplified it down to the basic level because I noticed one of my other streamers I watched, they have a simple setup and it just looks so much better. I have the Mad Force logo in the corner and my webcam in the other, and just like a simple chat bar. That's all you need. It's nice having an overlay, but it's just sometimes it just takes up too much of the screen. And if you want to do a clip compilation, it's sort of like it ruins the clip compilation. That's just my opinion, though.
Thank you.
Don't see I've fucked myself already.
Thank you, and please visit again.
Thankfully, no. Take the global chat off screen because it's a bit ugly. It don't need to see all that. sake. Because I'm going too fast. I like this gameplay, it's proper chill. Something to be said for pew pew gameplay, as some people call it. But I like the simple gameplay loops. Salvage, cargo hauling, repair, refuel, medical. Oh, it's nice to get stuck in sometimes and headbutt someone, but let me know if the game audio is too much louder than me. Ah, God. Because it's really loud in my ear, but the game is pretty loud anyway. Some of the ship engines are so deafening. To make sure I get every bit of salvage on this. So I can progress to the next level. 315p, that's 5,000. Fucking, that's expensive. 20,000. Jesus. Arkel 2. Yeah, well, fortune favours and all that. When I had my old RAM in, every time I go into a quantum jump, my computer would freeze. So, like, now I can just go in. Perfectly fine. No stutter. Nothing. Oh, sweet. My guns have saved. Accidentally destroyed my ship a couple of weeks back. It looks like the insurance is carried over for those. Yeah, definitely. I mean, there's a couple of planets where, like, there'd be certain particle effects, like clouds, that would affect the game massively, and so I'd have to turn those off, and even then I'd still have some issues with the planet. So it's like, none of the sides are interactive at all. So what I'm doing in the moment, I'm sort of trying to progress my way through the salvage loop so that I can get bigger, better salvage jobs, and I can fill up more in me vulture and me reclaimer if I get that far. So I went from a 1k salvage job to like a 20k job, so see if we can get better than that. Quantum fuel's running low. Quantum drive is now Make a quick stop at the station to refuel. Actually, first. Ah, crap. Didn't put any drinks on board. Hey Buzzer, how's it going? Yeah, it doesn't seem to be running
Thank
too
you.
Bad.
And please visit again. Please proceed to assigned landing bay. Hello. And thank you for contacting EDL Landing Assist.
Landing gear down.
Break. Seven.
Quantum fuel is at 100%.
As you can tell, I've gotten pretty used to the flying mechanics now. And get pretty close to stations and stuff. Yeah. Yeah, so everything's so much smoother, Bazza, with this new RAM. I'm not getting nearly as many freezes. Getting the odd one here and there, but just as much as everyone else does with this game. Oh, it is, it's buttery. Every time I used to go into quantum jumping, it's like he used to just freeze up until I got to my location. No problem. Yeah, so he's using Americanism there. Keep forgetting this is an industrial ship. Not like a light fighter, so I keep forgetting it takes a lot more to slow it down, so I keep flying past everything. It's like trying to fly a truck. Hey Claire, how's it going? No problem, thanks for popping in. Appreciate all the lurks, all the views. Not doing anything too exciting today, just doing a bit of salvaging this game. Come back, Bazza. So at the moment with this ship, the Vulture, all I can do is strip like the outer shell off, which is like what I'm doing here. It sort of like leaves all the mesh underneath. Eventually, when they bring Salvage 2.0 in, and I'll just stop this here. So these are the paint strippers at the front. Oh yeah, it's proper like jet washing. These side things where the red lines are they cut everything, they're like tractor beams, they cut everything down as well. And then at the front of the ship underneath the pilot seat, although these don't work yet, is these like grinder things. They chew everything up and spit the materials out into like a little box. So as you can see in my cargo over there, there's already a box there and I'm filling one up at the moment. already filled two boxes up, so I need to move one out of the way to get the other one out. It's only like a small ship, this, so it's got its own like toilet and shower combo, bedroom, food station, all the ship components to make the ship run are here. Eventually I'll be able to fix and maintain those. So I can get about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, get about 18 boxes in here in total of salvage. One of the most chill things to do in this game. There's a lot like mining, cargo hauling, little box delivery missions and stuff like that. But there's a lot that requires combat, which I'm not really that keen on. So I try and avoid all the combat. I do it now and then, but for the most part, I like doing this. Yeah, I mean, it does have like third person mode, but you can't operate in third person mode yet. I'm hoping eventually they do add, because Zido gets motion sick from watching me play this, and Chrissy's played this and she gets motion sickness. But like, there is a third person mode, but there's no UI and no way to interact with things. As soon as you press the interaction button, it puts you back into first person. But it's still in development. This is an alpha, so it's not a complete game. So it's like, they might decide, because they do want to add different ways of viewing the game. They want to add VR and stuff like that. I mean, it doesn't even know. There's a lot of ships that I've bought that I can't even fly yet because they're still being built. Hey Kev, how's it going? So, Borough VC is my brother. I'm not sure if it's... I think this is probably the second or third time I've seen you here. I can't remember. So as you can see, it's running very smoothly, by the way. Were you up to today, Kev? Yeah, no problem. Actually, whenever you're available, because I don't know when you work or not like that, so it's like, just come out when you can, you know. There might be cables in there that I can install the SSD, but I don't think I've got the bracket for it, so I might need to buy that anyway. I might not be able to install it, but at least you can have a look at it. Dizzy. I'm a bit too chicken to play that game. I'd know for a fact I'd just get ganked all the time. Something is moving in the back of my ship. Oh, I'm hitting invisible debris. Oh, that's what's happened.
You are clear to launch.
It's bugged out. I think one box is not registered and it's pushing the other one out. Alright, cool. What happened to your bikes, like? Ah, right. I remember biking to B&Q. I used to get knackered all the time. Then I give me bikes to you. It was just easier to walk. I thought it would make it easier just to ride to work, but not really. You're still expending the same amount of energy. Obviously it depends on the distance. I used to only live like 20 minutes away from me store. I couldn't bike to the Stockton one. Especially since it's over the other side of the A19. No problem, Kev. Enjoy your stream. Have a good one. peeling an onion. See if the box has moved. Must have just been a bug, that box. Probably wasn't actually there. Well, I'll probably do is fill up as much as I can from the hull of this ship and then see if it's got anything in its cargo bay. I think I've got much of everything I can from this. Just have a quick look at the back. Freaking sun's always in my way. That's a big fuck all. Well, that's disappointing. Wonder if I can... Hey, Mufasa. Yeah, got it back yesterday. I was playing with Aldo yesterday. I thought he would have... Wait a minute.
Thrusters power low. Weapons power low. Thrusters power low. Shield off.
I wish it was a way of finding whether the ports were unlocked. So I've unlocked the 20,000 UEC salvage missions. Fuck, I've locked it. I think the ship's slightly spinning. What the? I thought the freelancers were supposed to have the components removable. Maybe it's in the next update. There we go. I'm looking forward to component removal in ships. I'm looking forward to being able to munch the ships. It will really make salvage the most ultimate profitable game loop. I suppose as well you'll be able to siphon fuel eventually, remove ammo. Not a big fan of Omnisky cannons. I was hoping that it'd have a couple of attritions. I was hoping it'd have the attritions on, but the Max mustn't have the attritions. Just the free. I think my base freelancer there has attritions on them, but. I guess these ships don't. Let's check the salvage missions. I've got access to caterpillars and hammerheads. Drake Cutlass, Argo Mole, Caterpillar. It's a 50,000 one, like, but Valkyrie. I've got the high end ones. So when we do our Mad for salvage runs, I'll be able to get the big boys out. We could take the reclaimer out. So forward to unleashing the claw eventually. Right, I'll take these bad boys back to our corp. Smacked in the head there. Just check who that was who went. That is my friend Kristen. She's promoting a stream tonight. It's Kristen there, she does like a variety of games. Canadian streamer, does interviews, quizzes. A lot of different variety content. She's a good friend, been friends for many years, even before streaming. And a ruthless GTA gamer and Red Dead gamer. She used to just choke me out for no reason. I knew you'd respond to that buzzer. Maybe I should have got a giggity emote for every time somebody says something that could be taken out of context. I used to have one of those Freelancer Max ships. I wasn't keen on it. The undercarriage used to just get caught on the hangar floor. It was such a heavy ship. I think they fixed it now, like, but I got rid of it. I've got the smaller version, the Freelancer DUR, which is an exploration variant. Freelancer Max is a bit heavier ship because it's got a fat ass. Which means you can carry more cargo. I just didn't like how heavy it was to get off the ground. But I like the Freelancer series, I like all MISC ships. Very industrial, and that's what I like. Same as Drake ships. This is a Drake ship. And it's very industrial. I mean, you got your posher ships as well, like Origin ships, Crusade ships. They look like you should be flying it with a glass of champagne in your hand and a cigar. Too clean and sterile, but there's some nice ones. Origin do like mainly yachts and stuff like that. Head over to our corp. The glare of that sun is so fucking ridiculous.
Quantum drive is
at us. Good. Cameras turned off. So basically, with the camera, I can actually, if I switch it on, I can make my face move, but it's turned off at the moment, so it won't. But it'll follow, like if I smile, it would smile. If I move my eyes, it'd move my eyes and move my brows. If I talked, my mouth would move. But the only thing is, if I had it turned on, it would, for some reason, I couldn't use the camera on OBS. Stream element. Fucking warm. Just check the temperature. It's only 21, it feels warmer. Could be the PC as well, there's probably a lot of heat coming off that. This is the dark side, so hopefully on the other side it's daytime at ARCOP, Area 18. So they've recently added clouds to ARCOP, which look nice, but they block off the view of the air spaceport, so it's hard to find where to land. But with it being daytime, it should be a lot easier. You need big flashing lights that pierce through the clouds and can't tell. Right, so if you've got the skyscraper in your rear, fly away from it. That's what I was told yesterday. Like, past the city. What the need, though, for this game is for you to be able to add a... They need to add a beacon marker above the spaceport itself. There's the convention centre. It's that big round circle thing. They have like a ship convention every year. Well, not always in that one. But each planet in the system seems to have its own convention centre now. Apart from Hurston. Like a little sky tram that takes you to it. There's a ship marker, so hopefully that's where the spaceport is. There's more. So I think I found it. Yep.
Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
There's someone taking off. That little white dot. Somebody else about to take off. In that little hangar there, there's a little Pisces, which is like a little snub ship that looks like oh shit, there's another vulture. Same ship as mine. I think he's looking at that wrecked ship on there, so he's wondering if he could salvage it or not. It's an armistice, so you can't. There's a cutlass black there on its roof in bits, so it's probably come in too fast. I seen him dip his nose down and thinking, can I salvage it or not? No, you cannot. There's more wreckage down there. Probably night time and I can't see shit. Just crashed into the planet because they couldn't see shit. Hey Chrissy, thank you very much. How do you like the crispy new layout? Oop, injured myself there. So I'll show you a couple of the things. Obviously, you could see it's got the chat window up. There's no way of actually showing the alerts off, but there's some way of showing the alerts, but I don't know how. Hang on. I need to add the soundboard on for that one. Where is it? I did have it on. I'll just put it back on, see if it works. It's part of voice mod. There's a lot of things I keep remember to enable. Yeah, there's a couple of redeems that don't work at the moment. It's been a while since I've had to use them. Just trying to verify voice mod with it's not working. I might change it anyway. I might put blurp on there just. Oh shit, I didn't mean to click that. Voice attack. Got so much shit on me, like little shortcut bar, it's like unbelievable. Probably you remember this landing zone, Chrissy. This is the one you started out in. The one that's like a big massive city. It's another player that there's two players there. Few players. They're doing a free fly at the moment, which means people could play this for free. Usually do it for a week every now and then. Oh, somebody's injured themselves. Medical rescue. Bugs. Investing in tomorrow's future. Hmm. There's all the hangars down there. That's where I landed in on. So sometimes, if you can stand here and you can watch the ships take off. I think when you played last, Chrissy, these clouds weren't here. So it was like just a bright blue sky. They've added clouds in now. Oh, there's a caterpillar. That's a big cargo ship. Let's see how he does. Oh, they're on the other side, so we won't be able to see it going into the hangar. As you can see, it's got the big long belly and its landing gear when it comes out, they're like the little legs, so that's why they call it the caterpillar. So it's got like four or five cargo bays there. It's also got like a cockpit section which can break off from the main ship. And then it's got like a little crew section. It's got like two turrets and that. One of my favourite ships. For now, I've got to go into city and sell off me salvage from me vulture. There's me salvage goods and there's the some weapons that are stripped off a ship. I think that guy's just running onto the wrong train. He's on his way to the convention centre. Sucks to be you. So up here, it even tells you where you're going, which is a pretty cool feature. You can either sit on the seats, or you can just walk about the tram and watch the city go by. And none of this is load screens, this is actually flying about the city. So like, people in the city would be able to see this fly overhead. There's like a little bridge down there that we just passed. That's where there's some shops. They could see this flying overhead. That's a bar there. Although the bartenders aren't working properly at the moment. Although they might now do. Arriving. The NBCs are working on this server, so let's have a look. To a Twitch. Oh, there's an update, that's why it wasn't working. So there's a moment, there's some NPCs walking about, but some of the starting spawns are broken for the NPCs, so over there. You can see all those NPCs stuck in the centre column over there. And because they're stuck in a certain column, they can't find the path to move to different places. So they're just stuck there in a group. Still downloading. So he must be in the caterpillar. He'll be selling all his trade goods. Vulture. Why can I not sell meat? Oh my God. So for some reason, I can't sell me scrap. I assume that's to do with the guns in the back of the vulture. That's annoying. I guess I have to sell the guns first. So, input microphone. Okay, just make sure voice mod's on the right setting. So if you do the redeem again, it should actually, I can actually hear them. Can anyone hear that? Try another one. I don't think it's working. Yeah, well, that's a shame. Updated it for nothing. I think you can change my voice in this, though. With some of the redeems. Can you hear my voice okay, though? Actually, let's see if the bartenders are working or not. bartenders are absent. Luckily, the space station in orbit, I've got 100 beers. So this little bridge I flew over earlier in the tram. There's one just coming in there. So there could be a player in that. And there's one that goes underneath down there as well. And you can actually jump on top of it and ride it all the way to the spaceport. What the fuck? So those weapons are worth nothing. There was no point in me taking them off the ship. Had to do that. He's a rude motherfucker. Should be able to sell me salvage now though, at least. Now those weapons are going out my cargo box. But let's see. I think I'll do a mission after this. Moment of truth, can I sell me salvage? Why can I not sell me gear? This is frustration. Well, that's bullshit. I know I've got stuff inside the vulture. It should be showing up. I'm annoyed at that. Don't go.
Stand clear. Doors are now closing. Keep conversations and low be closed. Share space with other travelers.
That was close. No problem, Claire. Enjoy your meeting because they're not enjoyable. But hopefully the meeting goes swiftly. You know how boring meetings can be. Unfortunately. Still getting a couple of frame issues, but that's due to the free fly being on.
Servicing the greater area 18 metropolitan area. We hope you have safe travels.
That guy's died recently. Hey Peter, how's it going?
Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
Ah, good. So, I filled up my vulture, and for some reason the goods aren't showing up.
Welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
Yeah, not too bad. First time testing the stream out with the new camera, the new RAM. Seem to be doing quite well. Hangar 3. Yeah, it does. It's a big relief, big sigh of relief that I can actually go to the different landing zones with like fog clouds on, without very few issues. See there, there's four boxes of salvage, but they weren't showing up. Oh, by the way, Peter, I've I've unlocked some of the high-end salvage missions, you know, the legal ones. So I've got caterpillars, hammerheads. So when Aldo's streaming one night, and if we can pull out a reclaimer, I've got the missions. It's about 50 grand a pop, like, but they're worth it. Could do. Oh shit. Just depends, I might be watching another stream tonight, but maybe on the weekend, maybe night, might be able to do it night. Just depends what time my friend starts streaming, because I think she starts streaming at 9 o'clock. It depends what time Aldo streams and what time he finishes. Because he has been starting earlier, so it might not even clash, so... No problem. Thanks for popping by. I appreciate it. Keep me. I'm looking at the chat and not looking at the camera. It's my first time, sort of like. It's going to take some getting used to. Oh, did he say he pushed back today's stream? I think when he says push back, it means later. Did he put an announcement out, like? Yeah, so it could be like it's been pushed back to later, or it could be pushed back to another day. Let's have a look, actually. See what it said. One PM his time. Oh yeah, that's what he said. He has a chance to see a potential new place to live, so he's going to look for a new house. So it could push the stream back later. So what I might do is I'll put my vulture at Bikini Point, and I might transfer the boxes to a cargo ship at some point. Or if one user on later on, I can transfer it to one of your ships. Let's see if this mod, voice mod thing works. Voice box. So I should be sounding very echoey on stream, like I'm in some sort of like large building. This one's called Cathedral. If it works, that is. No problem, Peter. Have a good one. And there's this one that sounds very sinister and evil. And there's this one, it's a Tannoy. It sounds like a... Hey, welcome to Vengeful Airways. Please put seats in the upright position. And close all trip. Yeah, is was it changing my voice at all on... Ah, balls, it's not working. I'll just switch the mic to the... Yeah, you know when you try and do something... fun, it never works. So I'll just may as well put it back to the normal camera. Normal mic, I mean. I had a voice changer that I can use for the stream, but it doesn't seem to be working. I mean, I should have Blurp on working on this.
Thank you for contacting EDL Landing Assist. That request has already been granted.
No, it hasn't, because I can't see me. Oh, there it is. Switch to a different ship, I think, and
welcome to the ASOP vehicle retrieval system.
I do a quick mission. Turn that off. There we go. Sun just coming up there. Should I do a protect site? Yeah. Stick that one on though. Call to arms. Why isn't it not working? There we go. That way if somebody attacks me and I kill them and they're a criminal, I can get So I've got hammerheads, valkyries, lion cores. I'm going to do a simple box mission if there's one. Right, so I've got to take one from one outpost to another.
System.
Which should I take?
Vehicle select. Your vehicle has been delivered to the following location.
Please visit us again.
So this is one of the luxury ships. It is the 400i. It's got a big long nose. And there's a bike that I've got which isn't out yet, but I'll be able to stick it in this little bay here. Nothing else fits in there at the moment. I've got another hover bike, but it doesn't fit in there, sadly. That's a bug. That should be on there. Component bays. Enough room there for a vehicle. So this is the bathroom, I believe. Yep. So it's got the toilet, pulls away. Shower head, sink, closet for hanging your gear up. Come down this part of the ship and then you've got the captain's quarters, which has a bed, underbed storage and a clothes locker. It's also got two desks that you can put shit in. And a computer, which eventually you'll be able to use to do stuff with. Room for two crew members. A navigation thingy, which you'll be able to use to plan your routes. Kitchen area, dining area. And then you've got your bridge. Two crew stations. And your captains. So, because my character's thirsty, I'm going to put a drink in here. That little teardrop thing in the bottom left, that's me drinking that. There's a crashed ship there. Somebody coming in too hot. The best way of trying to land on the station is not to fly directly towards the station, but as if you're flying past it. Because if you come in too hot, you can smash into the station. Whereas if you aim to go past it, you can always go past it and then hit on the brakes. It's like a big ship. Ships don't aim to go directly to the port, they aim to go towards it. And then they'll try and... Many times, Mufasa... But I assume you've done the same as well. You've sort of like flown directly towards a station and hit it. I think everyone has. Unless you've watched somebody doing it and learned from their mistakes. Definitely, yeah. It's two ways of looking at things in life. Either learn from your mistakes, or learn from the mistakes of others. Sometimes it's nice to learn from the mistakes of others, rather than your own. But it can't always be that way. Oh shit. Trying to look all fancy and ended up slamming into the ground. There's a broken ship. That's a caterpillar. Sucks to be them. He's got I think they've spawned a cargo box. They've got something in there. Could be loot. Though I might be an armistice, I might not be able to pick it up. Maybe. My multi-tool works, so I might be able to pick it up. I was going to put a vehicle in here, but if it's cargo I can... not steal. Liberate. Why am I? Ah, that was stupid. There's something you don't do. Don't leave your ship without your helmet on. What was that I was saying about learning from other people's mistakes? Drinks. 378. Is it just the one box or? Zero 16. I'm just a little bit worried because there's two boxes here to grab. I've done a deliver box mission before. And I've picked up one box and I've had to go back because there was another box. Just make sure there's no peeker balls lurking about. Try and fly a bit closer. We've obviously tried to land there and then tried to get some materials, not realising it's a crater, and hit the top of the crater, the back end of the caterpillar, and exploded. At least that's what I think's gone on here. See if there's anything in here. Unfortunately, I don't think I can get in to take the whatever's in there, if there is anything in there. That's not physical, is it? No. That's a damn shame. Anything up here I can salvage? Oh, there is. But that was a spot of luck. I don't know if this is a legal cargo or legal cargo, but I'm going to take the risk. I was hoping there would be a cargo box as well, like a, if he had something inside his ship, but I can't see it. Yes, that's it under there. That's what fucked up me vulture earlier, because I put guns in with me salvage, and it sort of like made the salvage unrecognizable. Well, that's good. So just got to deliver me a box off. Got a multi-tool on him too. No! You son of a bitch. Matt Dam 57. Sorry, Matt Dam, but all your shit now belongs to me. Why can I not remove that? So he's naked, but somehow he's got a... Oh no, this is actually in the... So now I just need to dispose of the evidence. Get off my lawn. Well, that was extremely lucrative. I went from having a simple box mission to having some cargo. And off to Wala. I wonder what's in those boxes. I might have to take them a microtech to sell them. Quantum drive deactivated.
Quantum drive activated.
Oh wow, I think I found one of the few landing zones that hasn't been cluttered with people's ships and bloody shit tons of mules. Not salty about that at all, like. I'm just sick of seeing landing zones cluttered with ships that people have duped, used for the duping bug and the seen shit tons of mules there. Because of a new Babbage that cluttered the commons entrance. And I was trying to land, I found a patch of land and I landed on an invisible ship. All me salvage, all gone. Nice. I'll take some of this stuff. So warm. Had to put my fan on. Starting to get lightheaded. My arms are starting to get shaky a bit as well. Good. I didn't check what was inside my ship at the terminal. I could have seeing if there was anything I could sell there. That was dumb of me. Ooh. All the mining heads I can. Chocolate bars, drinks. Right, be right back. One sec. I'm gonna have omelette for tea, and I'll probably have me pizza. I like a good omelette, but I'm still doing this. Probably have the pizza at some point later on. When I'm finished streaming. I'm starting to get a bit breathless, and I think it's due to the heat. So I think I'll see where I can sell my cargo, and then take a break, pass it up to someone else. So I've got 4 SCU of medical supplies. Where can I sell that? Arcop. I'll try and take them back to Arcop. Can always log out there at least. Dizzy.
Landing gear raised.
Why is there a quantum beacon at? Kirsten. Fingers crossed that these goods that I've got on board is worth something. I'll make do for all the salvage I lost earlier on. Of all the places to find like a wrecked caterpillar, I'd never thought I'd find it that medical mineral resource place. But it worked out for me. I've got like five or four? It's night time. No.
Quantum drive deactivated.
Someone take it off, so that might mean. Ah, there's a spaceport. Why can it spawn me in here all the time? So, like, I spawned in over that side of the city earlier on, and it's just pointless. You seem to spawn in at different random points when you quantum in. Can't see shit. Crash into that guy who's coming in down there, that blue light. And there's someone in coming in behind me, so need to be cautious. Shit. Almost hit the control tower there.
Warning.
What? Exactly where I'm going.
Have a pleasant stay.
Four boxes. Oh shit, I'm in into the cargo bay on my ship. Not the cargo bay, the internal storage of all the goods. I always forget to do that. Someone filling up with drink and food. That's what I love about this game. You can see people just going about the business without like running at someone. Think, oh, got somebody there. There must be an enemy. Shoot them. No, 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 no. Oh, you. I knew that was going to happen. Yeah, well. I like all the little details in this. You got like fans for air conditioning, adverts, and then you got this where it tells you like a proper bus in the real world would, or a train in the real world would. This is the ship I have, the RSI Apollo, which is like a medical ship. It's the civilian version, whereas the medevac, which is like got a white paint job on it, that's the more the military style ship. But this one I'm eagerly waiting for. But for now I have to make do with a loaner ship, which is the Cutlass Red. Got like a little hover stretcher on the Apollo, so you can put your patients on it and then hoover them up into your ship. And it's got like 6 beds, I think, which are, you can change what beds do what. Moment of truth. Can I sell these medical supplies here? And how much are they worth? Long building. Origin 400i. Can't sell. That was a waste. I can probably sell them somewhere, but I just don't know where. I wonder, can I sell them in here? Or will it be the same situation? Oh well, worth a try. Could try Dumpers Depot. Frame rates are getting a bit choppy now. I always get lost in here. Now I'm on the right track. Yeah, I think the server's starting to get cluttered. Oh, could just be Area 18. It's a queue. Fucking hell. Oh no, there's a console there. Please. Please. No. Yeah, well. Well, I guess I'll have to look it up on the internet, see where I could sell me stuff. For now, I shall just have a refreshing beverage. And I'll see who I can raid. Let's see who's streaming. Normally, with me playing Star Citizen, I'd stream. I'd go to a Star Citizen streamer, but I think I'll raid Cactus Snacks because I haven't raided him before. And he's a cool guy. Often is in some of our friends' streams, so feel free to say hi. It's a follow only, so you might have to follow, but thank you for watching.
Canadian, I do believe. Yes, there you go. A for Q. It's a raid. Hello. Who hath raided me? It's Solomon. Hello. Come on in. We're doing the top tier horror list. Hello, everyone. It's me, Cactus. Hello.